Hey guys, it is Priscilla from New York. Welcome back to my channel and welcome to another episode of Priscilla's English Lessons. I hope you are all well. This video is the international version of when to use may versus might. If you want to see a Bangla version, Bangla and English version of this video, it is probably the last English lesson and it will be linked down below and in the card so it's easier for you to access. So without further ado, let's just get on with today's video. When to use may. You use may when you want to ask for permission. Not just asking for permission, but formally asking for permission. You use may when you're in the workplace, when you're talking to a colleague, when you're talking to someone of a higher authority. Use may to one, show respect, and two, be formal. For example, let's say you're having a slow work day and you go to your boss to ask, may I leave work early today? May. Some people change or confuse may with can, but can is not necessarily asking for permission. Can questions your abilities. For example, you may hear kids, small children say, can I use the restroom? Well, of course they can. They can use their legs and walk over to the restroom. That's not what they're asking. They're asking if they can go to the restroom. So, they should be asking, may I use the restroom? Other examples include, may I go to her house? May I have this piece? Etc. You can also use may for possibilities. Possibilities meaning something that can happen. To clarify, here are some examples. He may become a witness. After using may, you always follow it with a present tense. He may become a witness. Become is the present tense. I may not be able to come. It may snow. Snow is the present tense. Come is the present tense. Something that may happen. A possibility. You use might for smaller possibilities, a smaller chances of something, or even a past possibility. Here are some examples. She might have graduated if she studied harder. She might have gotten her degree. He might have been successful. Smaller possibilities in the past. So that is basically it for today's video. This is very short but very important, especially in the workplace or whenever you're having a formal conversation with someone. I hope this video was helpful, and if you want to learn more and see more of these English lessons, the Learn with Priscilla playlist will always be linked right down below in the description box. If you like this video, make sure to give this video a thumbs up, comment down below whatever you want to see, and share it because you never know who it can help. And on top of that, please do make sure to hit the red subscribe button down below and hit the notification bell as well so that you never miss a new upload of mine. Thanks once again for watching, and I will see you guys in my next one. Bye.